In this video, we're going to work through the process of preparing your RIVAGE PM system for mixing audio. With it being a modular system based on flexible audio and control networks, there are a few steps to follow before you get to hear anything. After you've connected your system, synchronized the devices, and set the word clock, which we worked through in a previous video, it's time to open the setup screen and find the system config window. The first system window gives you an overview, whether you're using one or two consoles, one or two DSP engines, and which HY cards are installed in the slots. You can also see status indications for each connected I/O device. If you're using twin lane with RP/IO units, a HY256TL card should be in slot 1. Look at the HY slot 1 window to start setting up the twin lane network. Now you can see up to 8 RP/IO units and the DSP engine, and the number of channels assigned in the network is shown, along with the remaining number of available channels. Touch the first RP/IO unit to see which cards are installed. For each card you wish to receive audio from, touch the twin lane assignment button at the bottom, which will change from showing pull to the number of channels to be assigned with a check mark. There's no need to select output cards here, just inputs, because outputs receive audio from TwinLane rather than transmitting into the network, so you can keep the output cards showing 0. If you have a Dante card or a MADI card in HY slot 2 of the RP/IO and you want to pull inputs from it, you can select in blocks of 16 channels. Select as many as you need. Then you will see at the bottom right of the screen, the total is tallied. Touch Apply to assign all those selected inputs to the twin lane network. The audio from them will now reach the DSP engine. For RY cards with mic preamps, make sure With Recall is on, so HA Gain, Silk and Phantom power settings will be applied when a scene memory is recalled. Do the same for any additional RP/IO units in the system. If you don't assign the inputs to twin lane, it will not appear in the input patch grid. But remember to leave some of the 400 twin lane channels for outputs. To assign output channels to twin lane so they can reach the RP/IO units, touch the DSP engine in the HY slot 1 page. Now you can see a grid of all the output buses, direct outputs, and others. Touch the mix box and select which mix buses you wish to send through the twin lane network. Then do the same for matrix and stereo outputs, monitor, cue, and so on. There's no need to select a channel if it's going to output from a Dante, MADI, or Waves card in the DSP engine. Just select it if you need to output the signal from an RP/IO unit. Press Apply to complete the assignment. It's a frequent mistake to miss this step. You can make the output patch, but you won't get audio from an RP/IO unit until the twin lane assignment is made for the output signal. If you're more familiar with Dante, then this is the twin lane equivalent of making a Dante patch to get your audio in and out. You might also have a twin lane card in HY slot 2. In that case, you have an additional 400 channels to play with. It's the same setup procedure. Using the slot bridge, it's possible to carry audio channels from one network to another. But it's a fairly advanced procedure, so we'll leave it for another time. Instead, let's see how to set up I/O devices with Dante. A Dante HY card will work in any slot. Multiple cards can be used at the same time, either in the same network or different networks. Each card can handle the remote control of as many as 24 devices, with an overall total of 48 devices. Take a look at a HY slot with a Dante card installed. If you're familiar with the Dante setup of a Yamaha CL or QL series console, this will not be difficult to follow. Open the network window to see the slot IP setting. This will be auto DHCP by default, which is the best setting to use in most cases. Either way, make sure the slot IP setting uses the same network address as the rest of the Dante network, with a unique host portion of the IP address. Open the Dante setup to see the familiar range of Dante configuration options. If this is the only Dante HY card in your network, make sure Dante Control ID number 1 is selected. Otherwise, make sure the ID is unique for each Dante HY card or other console in the system, or turn the ID off. This numbering is shared between the Dante HY cards and Yamaha CL and QL mixing consoles. So, up to 4 Dante HY cards or other consoles in the network can have remote control of the other Dante devices. The console with ID number 1 will be the leader for setting latency, bit depth, and sample rate for the controlled devices. If the ID is off, no devices can be controlled via that Dante HY card. If the ID or secondary port status are changed, allow time for the setting to be applied. The secondary port mode determines how the rest of the network is connected. Choose daisy chain for small systems without a network switch. Choose redundant for larger systems that connect via network switches. The Dante patch name by setting will determine what can be set from the console. The default is this console and will allow Dante port names and patching to be set from the console screens. Otherwise, Dante controller software would be needed. This console gets disabled when an ID setting other than number 1 is set. Set bit to 32 for maximum audio quality where network bandwidth isn't a problem. Set latency to an appropriate setting as is recommended for the size of network. Be careful when changing the status of preferred master and sync to external. Both can affect the performance of the whole Dante network. If you intend to run the Rivage PM system using its own internal work clock, then both these settings should be on. And this Dante HY card should be the master of the Dante network. On the other hand, if it's intended for there to be a different master in the Dante network, switch both off. Then Dante will need to provide the work clock source for the Rivage PM system. So these settings are important to consider. Once made, close the window and start finding the other Dante devices you wish to connect with and control. Touch the blank box for device number 1, then select the online device list. Any device that can be controlled will have its modern name shown in a blue color. Select the device and touch OK. Within a few seconds, the device should be ready to control. Touch it to open its status window and see the available parameters on the right. Touch them to access the controls. If there are mic preamps with HA gain control, you'll want to make a patch and see the controls in the channel strips. So let's take a look at that next. Back in the HY slot page, see the Dante input patch and Dante output patch buttons. Open either of them to see the patch grid, with the HY card channels listed vertically and the mounted Dante devices listed horizontally. Make a patch as you would in Dante controller, or use the continuous patch button. Names given to Dante ports in Dante controller software will be seen here. You can also enter the names from the console in the system config. Find the port name tab. And the great thing is, twin lane devices also have port names. Select the device type you want to name at the top left, twin lane or Dante, or local IO in the DSP engine and the console. With Dante, you can label each IO port, and this label is shared with Dante controller so it can be seen throughout the Dante network. You can open the on-screen keyboard at the bottom in case you don't have a USB keyboard connected. For twin lane devices, you can label every port and every RY card, even every RPIO unit. All these names will then be visible in the channel patch grids, making identification that much easier. When you consider there could be over 1,000 inputs connected in one system. So, now you're ready to start your mixer programming and show setup as normal. Audio is ready to patch and channels can be named. And that's exactly what we're going to talk about in the next video. See you soon.